Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide, 'cause you know just what we need before we say a word. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. Can hardly speak. Peace so unexplainable. I can hardly think as you call me. Deeper still as you call. It's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. You are perfect in all of your ways.
It's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved.
You are perfect in all.
Yeah.
spoke a word. Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99. Oh, I couldn't hurt it. Don't deserve it, still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God, yeah. When I was your foe, right, you have been so, so good to me. When I felt no worth, when I felt no worth, you paid it all for me. You have been so, so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, and oh, the there's no shadow, there's no shadow you won't light up. Mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. Come on, there's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Come on, there's no shadow, there's no shadow you won't light up. Mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. Come on, there's no wall. You won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up. Mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. Come on, there's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up. Mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. Love of God, yeah. deserve, and still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love, God.
Today we're going to be looking at Matthew chapter 18. We've been journeying through this one book, and that's the book of Matthew, Matthew's Gospel, since September 7th of 2020. Think about that. September 7th, 2020. We've been in this one book that has 28 chapters in it. And we've been in the same book since 2020. Wow. That's some good stuff. Must be some good stuff that I'm talking about that saying let's this long get through this one book, these 28 chapters. Because what? Today's the 9th. Today's Sunday, January the 9th, 2022. So from 2020 all the way to 2022, we're at chapter 18. Well, I want to welcome you this morning. But before we get into this, looking at, scripture, we're going to talk about greatest in the kingdom of heaven. But before that, I just want to say that the disciples sure argue a lot, about who was the greatest in the kingdom. What did Jesus have to say about these arguments and all of our arguments about who is the greatest? As we go about this chapter, as we go about, not just this whole chapter, but as we go about this first section that talks about the greatest in the kingdom, I want you to think about this question. What did Jesus have to say about these arguments and all of the arguments about who is the greatest in the kingdom? Think about that question as I read verse 1 to verse 9 to you today. In Matthew's Gospel, the 18th chapter, verse 1, it says this. At that time, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, "Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" He called a little child and had him stand among them. And he said, "I tell you the truth, unless you change and become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whoever humbles himself like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever welcomes a child like this in my name welcomes me. But if anyone causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him to have a large millstone hung around his neck and to be drowned in the depths of the sea. Woe to the world because of the things that cause people to sin. Such things must come, but woe to the man through whom they come." Verse 8, it says, if your hands or on foot, or your foot causes you to sin, cut it off and throw it away. It is better for you to enter life maimed or crippled than to have two hands and two feet, and your eye causes you to, and be thrown into eternal fire. Verse 9 says, "And if your eye causes you to sin, gouge it out and throw it away. It is better for you to enter life with one eye than to have two eyes and to be thrown into the fire of hell." Let me stop right there. Think about that. It says that if your hands and your feet are causing you to sin, to cut it off and throw it away. And then if it says, if your eye is causing you to sin, take it out and throw it away. Wow, this is actually, after reading this, it brings me back memories from Matthew chapter 14. Where Matthew chapter 14, it talked about the head of John the Baptist was cut off. That's pretty much what this is bringing me back to. Because, you know, John the Baptist, his head got cut off. And then now it's saying, if your hands and your feet and your eyes are causing you to sin, throw it away. Cut it off or take it out. Cut off your hands and feet if it's causing you to sin and throw it away. And take out your eye if it's causing you to sin and throw it away. Who is the greatest? Who is the greatest in the kingdom? I don't know. I know that God is, in my opinion, I think God's the greatest, but who's the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? Think about that. We're at verse 10, and verse 10 starts to talk about the parable of the lost sheep. You see, the parable of the lost sheep, but before we get into that, as you recall, in Matthew chapter 13, we talked about parables, and that whole entire chapter was based on parables. And I like the word parable being used, because the word parable means a lot. Like it says in Matthew chapter 13, it said the disciples asked Jesus, "Why do you speak to the people in parables?" Well, why do you speak to the people in parables? You see, the word parables, I like that word so much, because it tells stories. You see, Jesus talked to the people only using parables. And that's what it says in Matthew chapter 13. Well, you see, we're not at Matthew chapter 13. We're at Matthew chapter 18. And it talks about two more parables. And the first one that we're going to cover is the parable of the lost sheep. And it says in verse 10, "See that you do not look down on one of these little ones. For I tell you that their angels in heaven..." "For I tell you that their angels in heaven always see the face of my Father in heaven. What do you think if a man owns 100 sheep?" Wow, that's a lot of sheep. "And one of them wanders away. Will he not leave the 99 on the hills?" Wow, that word 99. It reminds me of that song that we opened up with. Reckless love. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, and leaves the 99. That word, leaves the 99, in that chorus. That's pretty much what it's based off of, right here. Because it says, he will not leave the 99 on the hills and go to look for the one that wandered off. It says in verse 13, "And if he finds it, I tell you the truth, he is happier about that one sheep than about the 99 that did not wander off. In the same way, your Father in heaven is not willing that any of these little ones should be lost." We're at verse 15. And verse 15 talks about a brother who sins against you. Before we get into that, talking about that, leaves the 99, "Oh, I couldn't earn it. Oh, I don't deserve it because I give myself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God." Wow. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus today. What some powerful words that is. What some powerful words that the person that wrote Reckless Love, Corey Osbury, put into that song. Because that song is based on what we just read. That song is based on the parable of the lost sheep. That chorus of the song is based on the parable of the lost sheep. Because it talks about leaving the 99, just like that song talks about leaving the 99, and this parable talks about leaving the 99. Wow. Let's continue. It says in verse 15, it talks about, again, like I said, it talks about a brother who sins against you. Sin. Think about that word, sin. You see, Jesus loves us. And actually, let me quickly go back to my notes from last Sunday. I know that sermon wasn't on here on YouTube. Sorry about that. I just really didn't feel like preaching it for the second time, but I'm gonna go back to my notes. You see, God loves us. God loves us. And because God's love for us, it is also God's plan to save us sinful human beings, from being eternally separated from Him. You see, God loves us so much. And you see, we all sin. You all probably sin at some point in your life. I know I have sinned at some point in my life. But we all sin. And it says in verse 15, if your brother sins against you, go and show him his fault just between the two of you. If he listens to you, you have won your brother over. But if he will not listen, take one or two others along, so that every matter may be established by the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell it to the church. And if he refuses to listen even to the church, treat him as you would a pagan or a tax collector. If I tell you the truth, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you lose on earth will be loosed in heaven. I heard that verse before. That verse is just so powerful. First time I heard that verse, I was like, wow. I think I read Matthew chapter 18 before. I think I preached it before. I think this verse was in one of my sermons before. Let me tell you what some powerful words that is. I'll tell you the truth. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you lose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Again, I tell you that if two of you on earth agree about everything you ask for it, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three come together in my name, there I am with them. Let me stop right there. Let me talk about verse 20. Let me reread verse 20 first. For where two or three come together in my name, there I am with them. Doesn't matter how many people are there. Doesn't matter how many people is in the room. You see, I'm in a room. Right now, I'm in a room just with myself. Bringing this message to you, bring this Bible study to you on this Sunday morning. But you see, wherever 1, 2, 3, 10 people, 5, 4, 3, 2, how many? Jesus is with us. You see, there's one person in this room, and that's me. And Jesus is here. Jesus is standing. I don't know if he is right here or right here. But Jesus is standing right next to me. Jesus always stands right next to me. Jesus always stands right next to you, because Jesus is always with us. And Jesus is with us right now. Jesus was with us yesterday. Jesus was with us today before. Jesus was with us a year ago. Jesus was with us a month ago. Jesus was with us 5 years ago. Jesus is always with us. Well, we're actually at verse 21, and verse 21 talks about this last parable. I mean, I don't want to say last parable because there's probably more parables. There's more parables to come along. But this is the last. But this is parable number. I don't know. But this is our last parable that we're going to talk about today. And it's the parable of the unmerciful servants. And it says in verse 21, then Peter came to Jesus and asked, Lord, how many times shall I forgive my brother when he sins against me? Up to seven times? Jesus answered, I tell you, not seven times, but 77 times. Therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who wanted to settle accounts with his servants. As he began the settlement, a man who owed him 10,000 talents, who brought to him, since he was not able to pay, the master ordered that he and his wife and his children and all that he had to be sold to repay the debts. The servant fell on his knees before him. Be patient with me, he begged, and I will pay back everything. The servant's master took pity on him, canceled the debts, and let him go. But when the servant went out and found one of his fellow servants, he owed him 100. Grabbed him and began to choke him. Pay back what you owe me, he demanded. His fellow servants fell to his knees and begged him, be patient with me, and I will pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he went off and had the man thrown into prison until he could pay the debt. But the other servants saw what had happened. They were greatly distressed and went and told their master everything that had happened. Then the master called the servant in. You wicked servant, he said, I canceled all the debts of yours because you begged me to. Shouldn't you have had mercy on your fellow servant, just as I had you on you? In anger, his master turned him over to the jailers to be tortured until he should pay back all he owed. This is how my Heavenly Father will treat each of you, unless you forgive your brother from your hearts. What some powerful words that is today, but not just today, but each and every day. We're about to get ready to end today, but before that, there's this song that I want to end with. And we need Jesus, and we always need Jesus. But there's this powerful song that I want to end with today. And this song's going to talk about needing Jesus today. Like I said, we need Jesus. And but before that, I want to quickly close into in a word of prayer. And then we're going to end with this song. But before we end, I just want to say, I just really appreciate all of you, being here, watching these videos. This is really, truly a blessing that I can share the word with, that there's a platform like this, where the word of God can go out to. Because let me tell you, there's people that needs Jesus. And this song talks about Jesus, I need you, and we all need Jesus, and there's people out there that doesn't know Jesus, and with this platform, I can spread the word, I can tell people that doesn't even know Jesus, I can tell them about Jesus, so they can know about Jesus, and Jesus is really a big part of my life, and it's probably a big part of your life, because Jesus loves us, and I know I didn't say this last week, during our first video of 2021, which is our Saturday worship last Saturday. But this year, my goal this year is to continue to spread the word, but try to reach more people. Try to reach more people by spreading the word, and I really hope I can get that subscriber count up this year. That way I know that more people is being reached, and that more people is learning about God. So if you have, if you know anybody who needs Jesus, I encourage you to share this, to share these videos with them, and to tell them that, and to tell them that God loves you, no matter what, that God loves you, because God does love you. So I want to pray, and then we're going to end our time together this morning with a song. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you for this opportunity. Lord Jesus, I pray, Lord, that no matter what happens in life, no matter what goes on this year, Lord, even though it's the 9th day of the year, Lord, but Lord, I pray that you will help us, Lord, that you will lead us, Lord, that you will guide us, and that you will touch us today, Lord. Lord Jesus, we thank you for all that you do in our life, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for helping us, for healing us, for saving us, Lord, and for listening to us when we talk to you, Lord, when we call your name, Lord, when we say, Lord, I need you. Lord, we need you. Jesus, we need you. Thank you for that, Lord. I praise you for that, Lord. I worship you for that, Lord. Lord Jesus, I pray all this today in your name. Lord, I pray all this today in your name. And in your name today, Lord, I pray. Amen. Amen. God bless. God bless. And I will see you. I think I'll see you on Saturday. Let me double check my schedule. I believe I'll see you next on Saturday. Let me see. Yes, I'll see you again next Saturday. I'll see you again this Saturday on the 15th. Because for our Saturday worship. Then I'll see you on Sunday. Then I'll see you on Sunday for us to start off this new series, talking about God and the heart of God. So without further ado, God bless, and I'll see you on Sunday. Not Sunday. I'll see you on Saturday. Be safe Sunday. So I'll see you on Saturday. God bless. Have a great week.